The NFL, NHL, NBA, and MLB fans usually don't need a reminder about who won the Rookie of the Year award in specific seasons. Everybody, and I mean everybody, knows who won the prestigious NBA award in 2004. Everyone knows who won it after the 2004-05 NHL lockout. And, well, every football fan should have a firm idea of who won the last few Rookie of the Year awards on both the offensive and defensive side of the ball. And hey, if you don't know, stick around to the end of the video and I might, oh no, I will, give you a rundown in case you forgot. It happens. But some recent Rookie of the Year award winners simply didn't regain that star-like form we saw in their first season. Because of that, we look back and see why they won the award and ask ourselves, really? I'm Justin Fraction, and today we present 10 athletes who you never would have guessed won Rookie of the Year. At TPS, we post videos every single day, so don't forget to click the subscribe button to subscribe. Then click the notification bell to be notified when we post a new video. Number 10, Tyler Myers. Just take a look at the first three Calder Trophy winners following the 2004-05 NHL lockout. Alexander Ovechkin, Evgeny Malkin, and Patrick Kane. All three of them have Stanley Cup championships, scoring titles, and Hart trophies on their resume. But after Patty Kane won it in 2008, there were only so many future superstars that would go on to win the Calder Trophy over the next decade. Take the case of 6'8" defenseman Tyler Myers, who won it as a member of the Buffalo Sabres in 2010. Myers scored 11 goals and 48 points that season, helping Buffalo win the Northeast Division title. Oddly enough, that would actually be the most points Myers put up in a season. He's been a mainstay on the Winnipeg Jets since getting traded there a few years back, but Myers hasn't regained the scoring touch that helped him win the Calder Trophy. Hey, it's still pretty cool that he managed to win the trophy over future superstars like John Tavares, Tuukka Rask, and Jamie Benn. Number 9, Jeremy Hellickson. The Des Moines, Iowa native has been your average Joe of an MLB starting pitcher. Through the 2018 season, Hellickson recorded a record of 74-72 with a 4.08 ERA and 898 strikeouts. Nothing too fancy, but nothing to complain about either. But Tampa Bay Rays fans sure remember Hellickson fondly. In his 2011 rookie season, Hellickson won 13 starts and posted a superb 2.95 ERA, striking out 117 batters in the process. Hellickson helped the Rays clinch an unlikely wildcard spot, going on a red-hot run in September to beat out the Boston Red Sox. Tampa Bay would lose to the Texas Rangers in the ALDS, but the historic run was incredible in itself. Hellickson was named 2011 American League Rookie of the Year for his services. He hasn't topped those 13 wins in a season ever since, and his ERA has been substantially higher than the 2.95 he had in his rookie year. Thus, it's hard to know or remember that this guy was once the AL's top rookie. Number 8, Sheldon Richardson. The New York Jets made a gutsy trade by sending Darrell Revis to the Tampa Bay Buccaneers in the 2013 offseason. They acquired a first-round pick in that blockbuster move and used it on Missouri defensive tackle Sheldon Richardson. The 295-pound Richardson pieced together one excellent Rookie of the Year for gangrene in 2013, posting 3.5 sacks and 78 combined tackles. Richardson ran away with the Defensive Rookie of the Year award as a result. But after earning his first Pro Bowl nod in 2014, Richardson saw his play on the field decline by a decent margin. Although he's still an effective run stopper, Richardson hasn't played like the guy who once won Rookie of the Year. Number 7, Giovanni Soto. The Puerto Rican catcher actually played bits of the 2005, 6, and 7 seasons, but he obviously didn't play enough to qualify as a rookie. But when Giovanni Soto played out his first season in the majors, back in 2008, he certainly didn't waste any time making an impact. Soto hit 23 home runs and 86 RBI while batting .285 with an OPS of 868. That helped him land the National League Rookie of the Year award, as Soto helped the Chicago Cubs win the NL Central Division. Soto also landed the first and only All-Star selection of his career. Soto has played for a handful of teams throughout his career and has, of course, not been able to regain that magical form we saw in 2008. That's why you kids have no clue he's a former Rookie of the Year winner. Number 6, Tyreke Evans. Stephen Curry, James Harden, and DeMar DeRozan were among the top players to come out of the 2009 NBA draft class. But while all three of those guys have become perennial stars, and two of them are MVP winners, it was actually Tyreke Evans who was named to the 2010 NBA Rookie of the Year. Evans had an excellent rookie campaign for a lowly Sacramento Kings team, averaging 20.1 points, 5.3 rebounds, and 5.8 assists per game. Strangely enough, that turned out to be the best season of Evans' career. Other players from that 2009 draft class have outshined Evans, and he's bounced around teams aplenty over the past several years. That's why it's so hard for us to know that he's a former Rookie of the Year winner. Number 5, Eddie Lacy. Boy, did this guy become an afterthought rather quickly. The Green Bay Packers spent a few years trying to find a quality and reliable running back to complement Aaron Rodgers in the passing game. They thought they found their guy in Alabama product Eddie Lacy, who was taken in the second round of the 2013 draft. Lacy added another element to the Green Bay offense and rushed for 1,178 yards and 11 touchdowns in his first NFL season. He was named Offensive Rookie of the Year for his efforts. Lacy had another strong showing in his sophomore year, but he became out of shape during the 2015 offseason and was largely unproductive that year. Injuries derailed his 2016 season, and Lacy would leave Green Bay after signing with the Seattle Seahawks. He only played in 9 games in 2017, and he remained unsigned throughout the 2018 season. But hey, he's an Offensive Rookie of the Year winner, so at least he's technically in football lore. Number 4, Chris Coughlin. It wasn't the biggest race for the 2009 National League Rookie of the Year award, but utility man Chris Coughlin won it as a member of the Florida Marlins after hitting 9 home runs and 47 RBI and finishing with a 3.21 batting average and 850 OPS. The bulk of the stats weren't all that fancy, but hey, Coughlin was going to take the NL Roy Award any way he could. Coughlin, of course, has just been your average bench player for the most part since winning that award. He was on the 2016 Chicago Cubs World Series Championship team, so hey, Coughlin actually has a pretty nice trophy room, even if he's not the biggest household name. Number 3, Steve Mason. The hype was high for Columbus Blue Jackets goalie Steve Mason in his rookie 2008-09 season. This man had backstopped Team Canada to a gold medal at the 2008 World Juniors. His rookie year was a piece of cake. Mason won 33 of his 61 starts and registered a 2.29 goals against average and .916 save percentage, along with an impressive 10 shutouts. Mason guided the Blue Jackets to the playoffs for the first time ever in their young history, too. Mason won the Calder Trophy, given annually to the NHL's top goalie, but he struggled mightily over his next 4 seasons in Columbus. He was eventually traded to the Philadelphia Flyers, where he experienced some minor success. Now Mason is strictly a backup goalie, having been bought out by the Montreal Canadiens before the 2018-19 season. At least his name is forever enshrined on that Calder Trophy. Number 2, Michael Carter-Williams. Drafted 11th overall by the Philadelphia 76ers in 2013, Michael Carter-Williams fared better than anybody expected in his rookie year. Amid the long and painful trust the process era, Carter-Williams gave Philly fans a lot to be excited about after his excellent 2013-14 season. The Syracuse product averaged 16.7 points, 6.2 rebounds, and 6.3 assists per game. That was enough to win the Rookie of the Year award, but Carter-Williams also appeared to be a classic case of beginner's luck. That's because the 6'6" point guard hasn't been able to replicate that success ever since. He was traded to Milwaukee in the midst of the 2014-15 season and has been used more as a backup point guard. Thus, it's easy to forget that the now sparingly used Carter-Williams was once your NBA Rookie of the Year. And number 1, Sam Bradford. His career has been marred by injuries and inconsistency. Sam Bradford, drafted first overall by the St. Louis Rams in 2010, is sure to go down as one of the bigger disappointments in NFL history. It's simply unfortunate that Bradford's knees gave out on him as often as they did. The Rams fans won't look back on the Bradford era as one of the better times in franchise history. He does have the 2010 Offensive Rookie of the Year award in his trophy room. Bradford threw for 3,512 passing yards and 18 touchdowns against 15 interceptions. The Rams almost won the NFC West too, but they lost to the Seattle Seahawks in a Week 17 win-or-go-home game. Bradford showed plenty of promise in his rookie year, but the injuries would pile up from there. But hey, he outshined the likes of future Pro Bowlers Demaryius Thomas and Dez Bryant for the Offensive Rookie of the Year award. So, And back to the beginning. Now, we said everybody, and I mean everybody, knows who won the prestigious NBA award in 2004. If you didn't, it's LeBron James, but you should know that. And we also said everybody should know who won it after the 2004-05 NHL lockout, and that, of course, was Alexander Ovechkin. And, of course, in the NBA for the past few years, 2018 Ben Simmons, 2017 Malcolm Brogdon, 2016 Karl-Anthony Towns, and 2015 Andrew Wiggins. Of course, we know who all those people are because we talk about them all the time. And as for the NHL, 2017-18 Matthew Barzal, 2016-17 of course Austin Matthews, 2015-16 Artemi Panarin, and 2014-15 Aaron Ekblad. And as for the Offensive NFL Award, that went to 2018 Saquon Barkley, 2017 Alvin Kamara, 2016 Dak Prescott, and 2015 Todd Gurley. For defensive, 2018 Darius Leonard, 2017 Marshawn Lattimore, 2016 Joey Bosa, and 2015 Marcus Peters. And finally, the MLB 2018 AL, Shohei Ohtani, NL, Ronald Acuna Jr. 2017 AL, Aaron Judge, NL, Cody Bellinger. 2016, Michael Fulmer in AL, and NL, Corey Sager. And 2015, NL, Carlos Correa, and of course, NL, Chris Bryant. What other athletes do people simply forget won a Rookie of the Year award? Join us in the comment section down below. And don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. We'll see you guys next time.